If you have ever purchased a movie recently, you've probably noticed that they all have one thing in common. They all come with a digital copy, but none of them work together. In today's video, I'm going to show you the best option for linking your iTunes, Amazon, Google Play, and Vudu movies. Let's get started. Hey everybody, welcome to Tech with Brett, where I help tech work for you. And in today's video, we're going to be looking at the new Movies Anywhere application. This app allows you to sync these four different accounts together so that you have all your movies in one place. Maybe you started purchasing your movies through iTunes. Well, if you did that, they don't sync anywhere and you can only watch them if you have an Apple device. And if you purchased them from Vudu and other things, you always have to download the multiple applications to use them. Well, today, I'm going to show you how you can set up and link all of those together. And if the movies are from a supported network, you'll be able to see all of those movies in one place. And then you can watch it from almost any device that you own. So it's a completely free service. Let's click here to get started. You can download this from many different places. You can download this on your Apple device, Android device, Kindle devices, and other smart TVs, and we'll get into that. So here you need to create an account, and I'm just going to choose my Google account. I have already gone in and set up my account before, but if this is your first time, it will ask you to connect your retailers. And here, if I want to go back in and connect some, I can click the settings, and then I can go to manage retailers. And then this will give me the option to connect those accounts. So when you click on Google Play, it will automatically sign in because here I have an Android phone. If you have Vudu, you just need to go sign into your account. For Amazon, you need to sign into that account and it will take you to the website and kind of run you through that and bring you back here. But if you have iTunes, so if you have an Apple device, you'll be able to quickly link iTunes. But if you have a Android phone or another device, you will need to link iTunes through your computer. So let me show you how to do that. To connect with iTunes, we just need to go on a computer that already has iTunes installed. Then we need to go to moviesanywhere.com, sign into our account. You then go to the settings and click manage retailers. You will then see the option to connect your iTunes. Once you select that, it will then open up iTunes and you will be given the option to connect with Movies Anywhere. You then need to agree to the terms and conditions and then sign into your Apple ID to connect your account. And here it says, once you connect this, your movies will be available in both places in the Movies Anywhere app, as well as through iTunes. Now that we have done that, we can go back, see that it's connected, and we can go back and see all our movies on the phone. All right, now we are back here on the Movies Anywhere app. If I go back, click the settings, say manage retailers, I'll see that my iTunes is now connected. If I want to disconnect iTunes, I will need to go back through my iTunes on my computer and click disconnect in the settings of the application. But these other retailers, I can disconnect right here on the phone. I can also set them as the default. So when you purchase a movie through the app, it will go to one of these to buy that movie, and you can click on there to set one of those as the default. I prefer Google Play Movies, but maybe you prefer something else. So then we're gonna go back and take a look at this app briefly. So right here, under the Explore tab, we have just all the movies or different franchises you can check out and if you wanna see more movies available through them. Next, we can go into My Movies and we can see all the movies that we have available. Then if we want to play a movie, we just open it up. We have a few options here. At the top, we do have the Chromecast, so you can cast this to any Chromecast device. Down here, I have Play. I can do a preview. And then I can save offline, so I could actually store this movie on my phone, so when I'm away from a network, I can access the full movie. And then you can see some more special features down here, and you can see other movies that it would recommend for you. When we play the movie, you have the skip forward and back 15-second controls. You, of course, have the slider down here, the volume up the top. You can then change the subtitles, so closed captioning, and right here, this only has English subtitles. And then we can also skip through and go to the different chapters here at the bottom. Then on the Movies tab, we can also sort by recently added. We can have the release date, A to Z, or Z to A. So you have all the options there. So if you recently purchased a copy that has a Movies Anywhere digital copy, you can go into the Redeem tab, enter the code there, and redeem it right here in the application. If you would like to purchase a movie, all you need to do is go to the Explore tab, or you can use the search setting at the top. And here, say I want to purchase Spider-Man Homecoming. I can open this up, add it to my wish list, preview, see more details about the movie, and then I can click buy right here. When you select buy, it gives you the different retailers you can purchase from. If I want to purchase from Google Play, here it's asking me if I want to set this retailer as my default retailer, but right now I'm just going to click no. And here it opens up the different purchase options. So I can buy from ultra high definition, HD, or just standard definition. And then once you click on that, it will take you through the normal process to buy from that different retailer. So right now, when you link multiple retailers, you will get 5 free movies. So you get The Lego Movie, Big Hero 6, Jason Bourne, Ghostbusters, and Ice Age, which is really cool. So if you just link one account to this application, you will get the Ghostbusters movie and Ice Age. And if you link a second, you'll get Lego Movie, Big Hero 6, and Jason Bourne, all for free. Right now, that's the limited time offer. If we go into the settings, we have a few different things here. One, we can say, make sure we only stream on Wi-Fi. Here we can see my saved movies, so the movies that you would have downloaded to the device. Next, we have the retailers, account settings. So if you want to reset your password or sign out, you can do that right there. Then we have the transaction history. So if we want to go in and see a movie when we purchased it, you have all the options there. And then we have the video data sharing. So if you want to learn more about what data is being shared, all the legal stuff, you can go in there. And then we have help center and about. And up here at the top, we have a really cool option. So right now I have a profile under Brett. If I want to switch that profile, you can drop down and choose a different profile here. There we can add one. So I've created a kids profile. And the cool part about this is it will then only show the PG movies for the kids. Now, they could, of course, easily go in here and change to my profile, but you can actually click the lock profile option. So say my kids only use this phone, I can lock the profile to theirs so they can't go and see the rest of the movies. And then whenever they go into this app, it will just show these movies that are available for them. So you can see that when I add a profile here, I have the option to change the avatar, change the profile name, and then set the rating right there. If you have synced all the different retailers, your iTunes, your Vudu, Google Play Movies, and Amazon, it will sync all those movies across each service. So now that I've synced these all together here on the Movies Anywhere app, I can go into my Google Play Movies app, and under my library, all of those movies have been synced together as well. If you find a movie that is on one of the accounts that doesn't transfer over, that's because that network is not supported on Movies Anywhere. And you can find out more details about that if we go into the Movies Anywhere app and we go to the Help Center. So here, if you find something that is missing, it's showing that we have Disney, Lucas, Marvel, Pixar, Sony Pictures, 20th Century Fox, Universal, and Warner Brothers. Those are currently the supported accounts. So here under system requirements, we can see what devices are supported. We have iOS, that means iPhone, iPads, iPod Touch. It has to have iOS 9, Apple TV. You can do that through the app on the Apple TV or through AirPlay. We have Amazon Kindle devices, so your Kindle Fire tablets. Android, so that includes phones as well as tablets, and I already have it on the Android TV. Chromecast, like I showed you, you can actually cast right from the application. Roku, we have all the different Rokus there. PC or web, so you can actually log on online and do this from Chrome, Edge, Firefox, Safari, and stream movies. And then you can watch them through iTunes, Amazon Video, Vudu, and Google Play. So those are all the different areas where you can actually watch the videos through Movies Anywhere. So this is a really cool service, something I've been waiting for a long time. My hope is one day all the different networks will be a part of it, so you have every video in one place, which makes it really easy so that you don't have to go back and forth from applications to see all your movies and to find out where you purchased one. So my recommendation is just always purchase in the same place, but this app is really great so that it can sync and link all of those videos together. I hope this video was helpful for you to learn all about Movies Anywhere and how you can link all of your accounts together. If you have any further questions, please leave a comment below. And if this is your first time here, I'd love for you to click the subscribe button so that you can be notified of my new and upcoming videos that are going to teach you how to use your phone all the way to your smart home. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you on the next one.